can turn the world on with a smile. You can take a nothing day and suddenly make it all seem worthwhile. What a true girl, and you should know it. Each glance and every little movement you show it.
Love is all around.
No need to fake it.
You can never tell.
Why don't you take it? You're gonna make it after all.
Hi, everybody. Jodie Emery here with another update. And it is a few days late, but that's because I got to go down to Georgia to visit Mark last weekend. So I was traveling home all day Monday, and I was very exhausted on Tuesday and pretty busy following up on Wednesday. So today is Thursday, and I'm filming the show late, but next week I'll have my regular Monday show available on Tuesday. And I'll tell you more about the visit with Mark after I give you an update from the last video. As you know, the Angus Reid Polling Company surveyed Canadians online asking about drugs and about Mark and his extradition and imprisonment in the U.S. Now, the question was incorrect in that it told people he sold marijuana and marijuana seeds. And I made a big fuss about it, and we got in the newspapers, we got quite a bit of media. I was on the radio, and so that went fairly well, bringing attention to how they were misrepresenting what Mark did. So I was able to get them to say that they were going to do another poll after the outcry of everybody out there letting them know that they had done such a great disservice. So they ran another poll and got some more information, although they lied and said that the first results were just a miscalculation, a technical error. But because the questions were so specific, we know that that's not true. And then they even tried to lie and say that they didn't even ask a question about Mark, which wasn't true. So they ended up doing another poll. And the poll came back and said that Canadians want the Prince of Pot home. So it said 54% agree that Mark should be able to come home, that the government should approve his transfer. And that's a good number considering all of the conservatives out there who are typically subject to the Angus Reid polling company. But they fixed the question, they asked a better one, and we got really good quotes where the Mario Canseco, who I brought up, who had done this poll and was the person to contact, he said that there's a bit of folk hero appeal when it comes to Emery in this country, and that he doesn't think we'd see something like this for anyone else in jail. And that he's not really, he pled guilty for something that Canadians don't really see as terrible, and why not allow him to serve a sentence here? So if you go to cannabisculture.com and you look at the older articles, it's just in the more section under the news stories, you can read all the details, or just Google Mark Emery, Angus Reid, Jodie, and you'll probably get the results. So that was good that we got some publicity out of it, and we were able to bring attention to what Mark really was extradited for, seeds, which, you know, the media has even started saying that he was spending the money on the movement. Today, for example, I got a notice from Maclean's. They did a little segment on Mark saying that he generated millions of dollars to fund the movement, including runs for office, which he did. So that was good to see that they're bringing attention to his attempts to come home. So Angus Reid, that ended up being good, making a fuss about it, being sure to point out where they were wrong. And, you know, I'll defend my husband no matter what, so nobody better mess with him. And it was great to go visit him. I mean, it was such a long journey. I flew from Vancouver to Chicago and then down to Jacksonville, Florida. And it's just north a little into the border, only like 40 minutes, and you're in Georgia in Kingsland. So I was able to go see him for like 6.5 to 7 hours on Saturday and Sunday. And it's a really old facility, and it's run more like a medium security than a low security, Mark says, which is true. I mean, I was shocked by the amount of razor wire, double fencing. If you're on Facebook, I posted some photos on my account, so facebook.com/Jodie Emery, and you'll see the pictures as we drove up to the prison. So it's, you know, it's not a welcoming environment. The staff there are very friendly, so there is truth behind Southern hospitality. They're very gracious, but it's still horrible to have to deal with these people and go through this process. But I was able to sit with Mark. It's in a big visiting room, and there aren't any windows, but there aren't many people visiting because everyone there is a foreigner. So only very few people are fortunate enough, like myself, to be able to visit. And it's thanks to my supporters, the people who donate, who send money and say that they want me to use it to get to Mark, because it is expensive, but it's really our number one priority personally, because it's very challenging for both of us to be apart. And it's been getting harder during the holidays. I mean, it's hearing Christmas music and stuff, it's really heartbreaking when your loved one isn't with you. So I understand what so many people are going through, and some people have lost loved ones forever to death, and some, you know, will lose their loved ones for much longer in prison in the U.S. So I'm grateful Mark will hopefully be home by this time next year, but it's been very hard, and I'm so appreciative for everyone to their help getting me down there to see him. So he's doing much better. He's tanned because he's able to get outside in the sun. And after seeing him in SeaTac for 5 months, where he was pale and sickly and didn't get any fresh air, it really makes me feel much better to see him with a healthy glow to his skin. And he's working in the library, which he loves. He's able to sort the books and order books and help a lot of inmates with their paperwork and forms, and most of them don't speak any English. They're all Spanish-speaking, so because the staff don't speak Spanish, and Mark doesn't either, but he's willing to work with them to get things done. He actually was moved yesterday with all the other inmates in his unit to a filthy, horrible section of the jail where the toilets were backed up and just grime everywhere, and they said it would be for a few days because the heater broke in the unit they were in. So Mark was like, telling me it was pretty horrible, but he also called today and let me know that they've been moved back. But they said they lost some of his mail and they're trying to find it. And all of this is just symptoms of how disorganized this place is. It used to be a state prison, now it's federal. None of the employees really know what to do. Mark is helping figure out most of it, which is really great that he's able to help all these other inmates and help the staff figure things out. And so it was just so wonderful to see him. I was so happy to be able to hold his hands, and there were some vending machines, and you can bring in a clear plastic bag with $20 in coins or bills, only $1 bills, and be able to use the vending machines. And it was the first time that Mark has been able to make a personal choice in so long. So there's this vending machine of sandwiches, and it was basically just meat and bread of different variations and low quality for that matter. And, you know, he was so excited to be able to have the choice of, you know, picking the food that he was going to eat. And so we got some chips and he got some chocolate and, you know, really enjoyed being able to eat all of the food that he got to choose, even though it was so unhealthy. But he's been able to eat better food with, like, salads and rice and beans. You can have as much as you want at mealtime, along with the main course, like chicken or whatever it is. So he's staying as healthy as he can, and working in the library, helping people out, really makes him feel good and really makes him feel productive, which lifts his spirits. So he's busy all day, earning 29 cents an hour. It's better than the 12 cents an hour kitchen jobs, but you know, he's happy to be able to help people out and keep busy because time flies. And he writes me a letter every night, and he also tries to write back to everybody who writes to him, but he's running low on time, so please forgive him if he doesn't get back to you, but he's very grateful for the mail he receives. So please take the time to send Mark mail, especially in the holiday season. Some cards would be wonderful. Other inmates are artists, so they would enjoy seeing some, you know, scenery and pictures and things to inspire them to draw and paint and whatever they're able to do. So please send Mark some mail and letters and photos and even magazines and paperback books you're able to send in the mail. Hardcovers have to be ordered online at Amazon.com or elsewhere. But you might not want to go to Amazon.com if you support WikiLeaks, but that's entirely separate matter for those who know. But do order books and send books to Mark and help him out through this time when it's the holidays and it's really hard to be apart. So Thank you so much, everybody, for your support. Continue going to freemark.ca and cannabisculture.com for the different ways that you can help. And we really need people to write letters to the Public Safety Minister and the U.S. Department of Justice to let them know to bring Mark home. And I'll be posting guidelines for that letter online today. Our lawyer that we hired with the Money Bomb Money has worked with us to create a list of what you should write about in asking for Mark to be sent home. So stay tuned. freemark.ca and cannabisculture.com. Write Mark a letter and get involved with everything else that's going on. And one last point that you should go to cannabisculture.com to read. Bill S-10, the mandatory minimum prison sentence bill for Canada, where our mass incarceration of cannabis consumers and growers would take place. We said it passed in my last video, that it passed the Senate and was going to the House of Commons to be voted on. But that was a mistake done by the media. It actually didn't pass, and our own Jeremiah Vandermeer, the editor of Cannabis Culture, who has Weed This Week, which is now Cannabis Culture News, every Friday at 4 p.m. Pacific time, he called up and found out the true story, and it took him a couple days to get the truth, but it has not passed yet, so we have a little bit more time, just by the grace of the ganja gods. So get out there, contact your member of parliament, go online to whyprohibition.ca. There's a form on the front page where you can contact your member of parliament and tell them not to vote on this in the House of Commons, not to approve it, because it's just so wrong and so evil what they're planning to do to cannabis culture throughout Canada. So go to all our websites, stay tuned, and I'll see you next week.